I agree with everything that's been said so far. We need to end mass incarceration. We need to stop police brutality. We need to oppose white supremacy and fascism whenever and wherever they appear, even if it's the President of the United States who's promulgating those things. Absolutely. We need to abolish the death penalty, which is a racist institution and has been from the beginning, and it's time to stop that 100%. We've got to end the war on drugs, which has also been used as an excuse to overly police and abuse people of color across the country. The war on drugs is a massive failure, and it's actually one of the main drivers of immigration as well into this country. Right now, they want to, you know, Trump wants to put a wall on the Mexican border. There's actually more Mexican people leaving this country than coming in. The bulk of people coming across the border are Central Americans who are fleeing horrific violence. Now, I mentioned earlier that I did a hunger strike in 2009 after I came back from Honduras. I was there with a group called Witness for Peace. And in Honduras, I went to the city of San Pedro Sula, which is on the northern coast of Honduras. It is the most violent city in the world. It has had that distinction even during, I think probably the war in Syria has meant there are cities there that are more dangerous, but even during Iraq and Afghanistan, more people were dying in San Pedro Sula every day than in those war-torn countries. And it's our country that drives that violence. It's the demand for drugs in this country. We've got to decriminalize drugs. That's the only way that we're gonna stop this. We've gotta legalize marijuana right away. And we've gotta make sure, thank you. We've gotta get farmers allowed to grow it as well. We can't have people saying that this is not our problem. This is our problem. We have to own it, and the only way we're gonna fight immigration is if we get to the root causes, which are poverty and violence. Thank you.